A new feature of the latest version of Keynote, version 7.1, allows you to embed your finished Keynote presentation in some popular website authoring tools, like for instance WordPress.com or Medium.com. So let me show you how it's done, because it's not very intuitive. It's part of the collaboration feature, which kind of is counterintuitive because you're not trying to collaborate, you're trying to actually just show people, you know, a presentation you made. So let's say, for instance, I wanted to take my Improving Your Passwords presentation and put that into a post I was doing about it at one of those two popular blogging sites. How would I do it? Well, first I'd go to the Collaborate tool, which you see up here. I click on that and I want to start collaborating. I want to change the share options. I want it to be anybody with a link, because you're posting this publicly, so it's got to be for anybody. And I want to set permission to view only. Now I'm going to not add a password. I'm going to also set to copy link as how I want to get the information out, and I'm going to hit share. And it's going to start the collaboration. And this may take some time, especially if you've got a presentation with lots of images and things like that. It's got to put the entire thing on iCloud. So this is basically using iCloud to share your presentation in the same way you would use it to collaborate with somebody else. You get this link, and you can use this link for various things. I'm going to paste the link in here, and you can see here is this link for this temporary presentation I've done. And if I wanted to actually have somebody take a look at it with me, I could give them that link and that's fine. That's meant for kind of a work collaboration kind of thing. But the same exact link can be used to embed this into a blog post. So first let's try pasting this into a post at WordPress.com if you use that blogging platform. In the visual editor here, and it should be as easy as pasting that URL in here. But in my experience it doesn't work very well. I'm actually going to copy again. I've pasted it here into TextEdit, as you saw me do before, and this is formatted as plain text. You can see I can change it to rich text, but right now it's plain text. It actually included a whole bunch of extra information normally, and I just want the plain text. So basically by pasting it into a plain text document and copying it again, I'm now copying the pure URL, not, you know, a special kind of thing with a little preview and stuff. And I'm going to paste it here into WordPress and hit return. And it actually takes that URL and immediately processes it and figures out it's supposed to be an embedded piece of media. And there it is. I've got that embedded Keynote presentation. I can still write text, you know, before it and after it in here as a regular blog post. So I could have been writing some stuff and I could insert this in the middle. And you know, when the person is actually looking at this blog post, they'll be able to use these arrows here to go back and forth and even open for viewing in Keynote here, go full screen, all sorts of things. Likewise, you can do the same thing in Medium here. So here I am in Medium and I'm going to go in here and I'm going to hit the plus button. I'm going to choose Embed. I'm going to paste and return, and it will paste in the embedded Keynote presentation. It's kind of like pasting in an embedded YouTube video. It recognizes that this is a Keynote presentation and it's going to put it in there just like that. And I can still write text before it and after it and all of that. And the person will see it as something interactive in the middle of my post here on Medium or on WordPress.com. It may work at other blogging sites as well, as long as they use the same kind of code that WordPress and Medium are using. So if you use another way of blogging, you may want to give it a try. If it works, it works. If not, you can hope maybe that's added in the future, or you can just include it as a link for people to go and visit the actual Keynote presentation so they could view it at iCloud.com.